Ronni Chasen would have walked out of here just after midnight on Monday, or early Tuesday morning, depending on how you look upon it. But she went out to Hollywood to get her car from the valet. There's a camera up there that would have seen her. If she had gone into the hotel, there's a camera on the other side that would have seen her. Either way, somebody has footage of Ronni Chasen getting in her car. Here, at what was once a light post, is where her car struck. You can see that there are commemorative flowers, and the city's already put a barrier there. There's a newspaper, there's candles. But this is definitely where Ronnie's life ended. Now look, there's one theory you could consider. On Whittier, about 130 yards north of where the acclaimed Hollywood publicist's car was found, there's a stop sign. Everyone has to stop here. It's very well lit, and yet there's no point of view visibility around here at all. It's not inconceivable that the shooter or shooters could have jolted out here and shot Ronni in her car as she was stopping at the stop sign. That would have then led her to probably put her foot on the gas and go down the road about 130 and 120 meters, hitting that post.